प्राणानाम आलयं करुणालयं नमामि शंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्र भाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरौ गुरुरात्मेति मूर्ति भेद विभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्त देहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। ॐ सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। यो ब्रह्माण विदधाति पूर्वं यो वेदागश्च प्रणोति तस्मै तगुमः देवमात्मबुद्धिः प्रकाशं मुमुक्षुर्वै शरणं सम्प्रपद्ये। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। श्रीचिन्नगणेशाय नमो मह्यम्। सुखं नित्यं सत्प्रकाशं व्यापकं नामरूपयो अधिष्ठानं बुद्धिबोध्यं बुद्धिर्दुःखेत्युन्नतिपरम् अपारं सर्ववेदान्तवेद्यं प्रत्यक्परं महः तदेव अहन्नमत्वनिति मे निश्चिता मतिः। So in the Chaturtha Staranga, continuing with the Brahma Swarupa Lakshana. What is the Brahma Swarupa? We saw Chaitanya Ekadeshe Mayayaha Satvat. We saw there is Dvividham Vyapakatvam. And Brahma has Apekshika Vyapakatvam as well as Nirapekshika Vyapakatvam based on Saguna Brahma or Nirguna Brahma. So it is established here, Chaitanya Ekadeshe Mayayaha Satvat. Since Maya is present only in one part of Chaitanya, which becomes manifest later as a Prapancha, therefore, Maya Vishishta Chaitanya Pekshaya Shuddha Chaitanyasya Adhika Vyapakatvacha Tadeva Nirapeksha Vyapaka. So, what is Nirapeksha Vyapaka? The Brahma, which is Shuddha Chaitanya. Shuddha Chaitanya is Nirapeksha Vyapya. Vyapaka. Nirapeksha Vyapaka. Compared to Maya Vishishta Chaitanya, since it is only Maya is only in Eka Desha, the Shuddha Chaitanya pervades more, pervades, exists beyond the Maya also. Natu Maya Vishishta Chaitanyam. So Maya Vishishta Chaitanya is not Nirapeksha Vyapaka. Along with Maya, when it is Maya Shabalita Chaitanya, then it will be limited Vyapaka, because Maya is actually inferred. Inferred through the Karya. Karyanumiya Maya. And wherever you see Karya, you would infer Maya. Even if it is unmanifest in Pralaya, we assume that Maya exists because it is the Karana of the Prapancha that is going to come up later also. But that is Sapekshika Vyapaka Maya. Chaitanya which holds Maya. Tathapi yato Maya Vishishta Chaitanyam Paramartha Drishtya Shuddha Chaitanya Anatiriktam. This Maya Vishishta Chaitanya and Shuddha Chaitanya, if you give them names as Maya Vishishta Chaitanya or Karana Brahma or Ishvara, these are the names given to Maya Vishishta Chaitanya, Maya Sahita Chaitanya. Then we talk about avataras also. With whichever name of the deity you want to see Ishvara, that deity you pray to as Ishvara is supposed to bless you. Therefore, he has a Shakti to bless you. Kriya Shakti, Ichha Shakti, Kriya Shakti, Jnana Shakti has all these three Shaktis. These are all manifestations of Maya in Ishvara. That Ishvara, Saguna Brahma, Maya Vishuddha Chaitanya, if you compare with Shuddha Chaitanya, Satchidananda Brahma, otherwise called Satchidananda Brahma, Nirguna Brahma, that kind of Chaitanya, if you compare, What is the difference between the two? There is no difference. From the Vyavaharika Drishti, you see Ishvara. From the Paramarthika Drishti, there is nothing but Nirguna Brahma. Only in Vyavahara, the Nama Rupatmaka discussion is possible from the perspective of the Jagat. So the same Chid Brahma, Sad Brahma, Chid Brahma, Ananta Brahma appears to be along with Maya from the Vyavaharika Drishti and has no appearance at all. There is no Pratiti other than Swarupa, which is your own Swarupa from the Paramarthika Drishti. Drishti is used for the lack of a better word. Otherwise, there is no Drishti because there is no Drishya. Drishti is possible only when there is a Drishya, Drashta and Drishti Bheda. Only when there is subject-object division, you can have Drishti. Drishti is used only to compare with Vyavaharika Drishti where Drishti is possible because there is Drashtru, Drishya Bheda. Therefore, Drishti is possible. Otherwise, really in Paramarthika, no Drishti is possible. One cannot talk about anything there. But the same Shuddha Chaitanya appears as Maya Vishuddha Chaitanya from the perspective of the Vyavahara. Perspective of Vyavahara, because we are already in Karya Prapancha, we have to talk about Karana, then we talk about Maya Vishuddha Chaitanya as the Srishti Sthiti Laya Karana, but that Ishvara is not different from Parabrahma Shuddha Chaitanya. That is explained here. Tathapi yato maya vishishta chaitanyam paramartha drishtya shuddha chaitanya anatiriktam. There are no two chaitanyas. That's the entire teaching. There is no second chaitanya. So shuddha chaitanya itself is maya vishishta chaitanya. Although maya vishishta chaitanya is ekadesha of shuddha chaitanya. This is all mere hair splitting analysis. There is no possibility of dividing Chaitanya, taking a part of Chaitanya, but from Vyavahara, all sorts of assumptions can be made to take away doubts. For logical analysis, you can use a hypothesis. It is not idamittham. Therefore, we make a division between Maya Vishuddha Chaitanya and Shuddha Chaitanya, Saguna Brahma and Nirguna Brahma, and talk about Ekadesha of Shuddha Chaitanya, where Ekameva Advitiya Brahma Niravayavi, that kind of Brahma cannot have any Avayava or any Desha also. Desha Kala Vastu Paricheda Rahita Brahma cannot have Ekadesha also. But this is a perspective from the Vyavahara when we are analyzing as to who does what or who doesn't do anything. There these words are used. But never should we think that Shuddha Chaitanya and Maya Vishuddha Chaitanya, Saguna and Nirguna are two different. That is one extreme. And we should never assume that Nirguna Brahma acts is this Srishti Sthiti Laya Karana. Cannot be. Therefore, Maya is inferred and superimposed adhyastha on Shuddha Chaitanya to explain how Nirguna Brahma becomes the Karana. Cannot become the Karana, therefore Maya is inferred as his Shakti, and then you give another name to that Nirguna Brahma because he is along with this Trigunatmika Maya and call that as Ishvara, who is Sagunatma Brahma. But there is no difference between the two. But from Vyavahara Drishti, we should not say that Nirguna Brahma is the Karana, because Karana Brahma also is not. I mean, it is not that Nirguna Brahma isn't. There is no gender even possible there. So, not different from Shuddha Chaitanya. So, what is being said? Tathapi yato maya vishishta chaitanyam paramartha drishtya shuddha chaitanyad anatiriktam sat shuddha rupam eva bhavati. This maya vishishta chaitanya is not tainted. When you come down to the level of Jiva and qualify that Chaitanya with Antakkarana, Antakkarana Vishishta Chaitanya, Avidya Vishishta Chaitanya, Buddhi Vishishta Chaitanya, when you bring that kind of division in the Chaitanya, you, again from Vyavahara Drishti, then even शुद्ध चैतन्यात अनतिरिक्तम सत, स्टिल व्हाट विल हैपन दैट जीव अलोंग विद बुद्धि बिकम्स टेंटेड अनफॉर्चुनेटली एज दो अगेन एज दो व्हाई बिकॉज अविद्या वेल्स द चैतन्य तत्व फ्रॉम द बुद्धि इटसेल्फ विच इज द मैनिफेस्ट फॉर्म ऑफ अविद्या वी सॉ दैट सो शुद्ध चैतन्याद अनतिरिक्तम सत् दिस माया विशिष्ट चैतन्यम सत् शुद्ध रूपमेव भवति इट इज शुद्ध रूप अलोन सिमिलरली एट द व्यष्टि लेवल आल्सो व्हेन चैतन्य इज नॉन डिफरेंट फ्रॉम शुद्ध चैतन्य देन शुद्ध रूपमेव भवति जीव आल्सो एनीवे बट कमिंग बैक टू द कॉन्टेक्स्ट ऑफ माया विशिष्ट चैतन्य शुद्ध चैतन्य तस्मात् व्हाट हैपेंस देयरफॉर माया विशिष्टे अपि यः चैतन्यांशः तत्र निरपेक्षमेव व्यापकत्वम् अस्ति सो द एनालिसिस ऑफ ओ माया विशिष्ट चैतन्य इज नॉट देयर एवरीवेयर विद दैट थिंकिंग साधु सेज होल्ड ऑन इफ इट इज नॉट डिफरेंट देन वेयर डू यू ड्रॉ लाइन इन दी All pervasive tattva, you cannot draw a line. Tasmat maya vishishte api yaha chaitanya ausha. Even if you say eka desha, where maya shabalita chaitanya exists, shabalita is variegated. So variegated by maya, due to maya. Maya does not influence the chaitanya to become bound, however gives the shakti for shrishti sthiti laya. Otherwise there is no possible of सर्वज्ञत्वम् इत्यादि देर इज नो पॉसिबिलिटी ऑफ कर्म फल दातृत्वम् ऑल्सो इन चैतन्य दैट इज ब्रॉट अबाउट बाय माया एंड दैट माया विशिष्टे अपि यः चैतन्य अंशः तत्र निरपेक्षम् एव व्यापकत्वम् अस्ति बिकॉज इट इज शुद्ध रूपम् एव भवति एंड शुद्ध चैतन्यात् अनतिरिक्तम् देयरफॉर This sapeksha vyapakatvam for maya vishishta chaitanyam is also figurative from the vyavahara drishti. Ittham maya vishishta chaitanyam eva brahma shabdasya vachyarthaha iti yuktam eva uktam. Now when you are doing the analysis of tattvam asi, there this tatpadartha is maya vishishta chaitanya, not shuddha chaitanya. However, tat पदाम विच इज माया विशिष्ट चैतन्य इज शुद्ध चैतन्या अनतिरिक्तम दैट सगुण ब्रह्म ईश्वर विच इज द तत्पद वाच्यार्थ इज नॉट डिफरेंट फ्रॉम द लक्ष्यार्थ रियली देयरफॉर यू कैन ड्रॉप द उपाधिस उपाधि कृत भेद अस्ति न तो वस्तुतः भेद नास्ति देयरफॉर यू कैन रिमूव द उपाधिस विच आर क्रिएटिंग द भेद एज दो एंड देन लैंड ऑन The Shuddha Chaitanya, which was never different from Maya Vishishta Chaitanya. So, ittham Maya Vishishta Chaitanya, Brahma Shabdasya Vachyartha, iti yuktam eva uktam. But if you see what is the Vachyartha, it is Maya Vishishta Chaitanya. Vachyartha, the literal meaning of the word, in the context of Tatpadar, Tattvamasi Mahavakya, where Tat is Sat, Sad Brahma, The Chandogya Upanishad, in the sixth chapter, the teaching is Karana Jnanena Sarva Karyam Jnatam Bhavati. That is the conclusion. Initially, the dialogue or the dialect opens, the teaching opens with the question to the Shishya, the Guru asks, O Shvetaketo, have you asked your teacher? To teach you, or rather, has your teacher taught you that? Knowing which, everything becomes known. That one thing, knowing which, everything becomes known. Yasya jnanena sarvam jnatam bhavati. Shishya says, there is nothing like that. Otherwise, they would have taught me, I was a brilliant student. So he has a lot of ego and pride when he comes back home from the Gurukula. Because he is Chaturveda Pandita. Has a lot of ego, and when he comes back, father, punctures that ego by asking the question, which is the end goal of all life? cancer to which is the end goal of all life. Shweta Ketu is unable to answer. First he says that, oh, they did not know. And there, it's insulting the guru. Really, it is insulting the guru. But then Bhagavan Bhashyakara gives a little concession saying that the Shweta Ketu has fear of, you know, being sent back to the Gurukula because he stayed there for 12 years. He does not want to go back again. He went in late. I mean, he didn't go at a young age. The Upanishad starts by that story. He went a little late at the end of, you know, end of the term when a Brahmana should not stay at home. Otherwise, he'll become a Brahma Bandhu. He'll become a person whose relatives are Brahmanas, family members are Brahmana, but he is not a Brahmana because of Upanayana Samskara and Veda Dhyana lacking. So there is a particular age when it is allowed that, you know, a playful age, child can stay at home. But there is a range, age range for each Varna. This Shweta Ketu as a child has almost crossed that age. At the end term, he was sent to Gurukula and therefore he's come back when he's grown up and learnt well. But then Bhagavan Bhashyakara gives concession that he's not really insulting the guru. It's, you know, it's a mistake with the fear of being sent back. He wants to be at home. So that is the underlying idea there. But then the question which is going to give you sarvajnyatvam as though it is also figurative because the question drops. What is this prapancha? Who am I? How am I connected to this prapancha? Who is the creator? How am I connected to the creator? Then the creator and the created prapancha, what is the sambandha? So what are these three entities? The prapancha, the creator and me. What is the connection between all three of us? This is moksha karaka. Jnanena moksha. Now this jnana which reveals all this is at the root of all three, which happens to be Shuddha Brahma, which is not different than the underlying principle that supports the Jagat, which appears as Aham in each and every Jiva, and which is the Srishti Sthiti Laya Karana, at the basis of that also. And then the Prakriya shows in Chandogya that this Sat Brahma, which initially with examples as to Mridjnanena Sarvam Mritkaryam Jnatam Bhavati. If you know Mrit, then you know the Mritkarya as well. Or each and every product of clay is known once you know clay. So if you see something, you don't know what it is. You know, you see some object, you do not know what it is. You have seen it for the first time. But if someone tells you, oh, it is nothing but made of clay, oh, then you understand. It may have some utility, another name, all that is fine. Those are all superimpositions. Those are all mithya really. They are not creating a bheda in mrit really. Mrit remains mrit even in its karya. So Brahma Tattva, Satchidananda Tattva remains the same when it pervades through the entire prapancha. Also said in Ishavasya Upanishad, Ishavasya Midam Sarvam. Now this Tattva can be known, and once it is known, entire Karya is known, and this entire prapancha is Sarvam, known by the word Sarvam, which is Sarvanama. Sarvanama is the pronoun is what? It's a proxy noun, but Sarvanama with the word Sarva itself stands for everything. Sarvam Khalvidam Brahma. Once you know that Karya is never separate from Karana, Karya is just another Nama Rupa for Karana, factually not even Rupa, it is only Nama. Vacharambhanam Vikaru Nama Jhyam Mrityika Ityeva Satyam. So entire Karya is Mithya, having its basis in Vak, in name. Begun with a name, Vacharambhanam. Arambhana there is Alambana. Bhagavan Bhashyakara says, Ralayor Abhedaha. Arambha is Alamba. Alamba is, it's a support. The speech, what is started by speech, that itself becomes support for creating divisions. Thereby you see Karya Prapancha. The entire Karya Prapancha is nothing but Karana with a name, with a different name. So it is namakrita bhedaha, which is an upadhi. There is nothing called as ghatap or kumbha, which is separate from mrut. So karana bhinna karyam nasti. That is the teaching, entire teaching. Therefore, once you know sarva karanam, you know sarva karyam. That sarva karanam happens to be sad brahma, which is tat pada vachyartha in tattvamasi mahavakya at the end of the teaching, which is difficult to understand. Therefore, it is taught multiple times using various examples, gradually taking all the doubts away for Shvetaketu. Whatever doubts exist, Shvetaketu's doubts go across teachings. And Asakrut Upadeshaha, Navakrita Upadesha, 9 times that Upadesha is given, Tattvamasi, but each time the Tat remains same in Vachyartha and it remains same in Lakshyartha. Tvam is gradually led from Shvetaketu, who is son of the Acharya himself there, and gradually across 9 teachings he lands on the Pratyagatma, which happens to be Satchidananda Brahma. That Sad Brahma, which is Pratyagatma, which is Tvam Pada Lakshyartha, is non-different from the Tat Pada Lakshyartha, which is Shuddha Chaitanya. So Shuddha Chaitanya are the Lakshyartha of Tat Padartha as well as Tvam Padartha. At both levels, there are, at Tat as well as at Tvam levels, there are Upadhis which are creating the difference, as though they are to be removed, they are to be dropped by Bhagatyaga Lakshana or Jahad Ajal Lakshana. That is the teaching there. So here in this context, what is said is, Ittham Maya Vishishta Chaitanya Meva, which is called as Sad Brahma, as Ishvara, in another name for Ishvara rather, in Chandogya Upanishad, Mahavakya Tattvamasi, there Maya Vishishta Chaitanya Meva Brahma Shabdasya Vachyartha Iti Yuktamevokta. Now this is Tatpada Vachyartha discussion, but using what? Brahma here. Because Brahma, the word Brahma, can be used for anything. Anything in the sense, sometimes you will see Brahma is Sarvam Khalvidam Brahma. This is Idam Jagat is Brahma. Then you will see Tattvamasi, in that there, when Tattvamasi is said in one Upanishad, in another Upanishad, one gathers as Aham Brahmasmi. There Aham Brahma. So Sarvam Khalu Idam Brahma. Idam Brahma. Aham Brahma. There we have to understand the methodology in which Samanadhikaranam is being done. I mentioned it once, we'll see it some other time though again. But when Brahma is used, we have to understand whether it is Shuddha Chaitanya in the textual analysis. When you do Samanadhikaranam, whether it is Shuddha Chaitanya is being talked about or Maya Vishishta Chaitanya is being talked about. If Brahma is being discussed, especially in Bhashya, Brahma is said to be Jagat Karana. Or in Sutra, Vedanta Sutra, Brahma Sutra says, Athato Brahma Jidnyasa. Then that Brahma is what? Is the Sthiti, Srishti Sthiti Laya Karana. So when that Brahma is being talked about, Srishti Sthiti Laya Karana, then what is the meaning of the word Brahma there? When you do Brahma Jijnyasa, that time Brahma is explained as Srishti Sthiti Laya Karana. That time Shuddha Brahma cannot be Srishti Sthiti Laya Karana. We saw only Maya Vishishta Chaitanya can be the Karana for the Prapancha. Therefore, Brahma Shabdasya Vachyartha, in that context, Vachyartha is what? Maya Vishishta Chaitanyam. Therefore, Yuktam Eva Uktam. Vachyartha is, Brahma Shabda Vachyartha is not Maya Vishishta Chaitanya, is not Shuddha Chaitanya, is Maya Vishishta Chaitanya. In context, you have to understand in context. Shuddha Chaitanyam to Brahma Shabdasya Lakshyarthaha. And why so? Because Brahma is a name. Brahma is a naming done. Brahma. एंड अनदर श्रुति सेज यतो वाचो निवर्तन्ते अप्राप्य मनसा सह. यतो वाचो निवर्तन्ते अप्राप्य मनसा सेज दैट ब्रह्मा यतः यतः ब्रह्मणा वाचः मनसा सह निवर्तन्ते, मीनिंग विदाउट ऑब्जेक्टिफाइंग दी दैट. सो देर यतः इज यूज अगेन, सर्वनाम इज यूज देर बिकॉज ब्रह्म इज अ नेम. इवन दी नेम ब्रह्म, इफ यू से ब्रह्म तत्त्वमसि, व्हेन यू से देन आई से अहम ब्रह्म अस्मि, देर ब्रह्म, व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ द वर्ड ब्रह्म? The Shuddha Chaitanya cannot be really objectified by the name Brahma. It is not the direct meaning of the word Brahma. Yesterday we saw Brihi Vriddhau Dhatu, their Vriddhi is Nirapeksha Vriddhi, meaning Purnatvam. All these are ideas conveyed through words. We have to understand the meaning and drop the word. Brahma word itself cannot explain everything. Vriddhi also, nirapeksha vriddhi. When you try to analyze that, nirapekshika vriddhi, still that is not the words are not directly giving you the meaning. The idea that it generates, the jnana vritti that which takes place, that vritti also cannot reveal Brahma as it is. The prakriya is always going to be neti neti. Na iti na iti. Whatever notions we have about Brahma, when Brahma is explained through Brihi Vriddhau, then those ideas, those notions are taken away. So what is the role of any nama or any vakya or any shabda in Upanishad or elsewhere? In sutras, however it is not never going to reveal the meaning directly. It is not going to represent the tattva directly. That is the meaning of vachyartha. You will always need an indirection. You always have to analyze and land on the implied meaning. That implied meaning is your own swarupa. You being the subject, you can never objectify yourself through any word or through any manasika vritti. Therefore, manasa sa vinivartante. Vachaha, all the words written without being able to directly represent any swarupa of yours, any part, there is no part, because these words can only do so much. Without words, it is impossible. But words alone aren't sufficient. Words have to work, remove the ajnana, then what remains is you. It will always be neti neti. Even tattvamasi, aham brahmasmi, these vakyas, although they are called as mahavakyas, they do not give you the direct meaning as it is. They work only in this very way. When we say they reveal your swarupa, they reveal your swarupa not by words themselves. Words take away ajnana which is veiling your swarupa. The idea is always in any prakriya, with any mahavakya, however it is explained, even in mandukya, people think that mandukya is ajatavada, nothing has happened. Yeah, nothing has happened in reality when it is said so. That time it takes away your misunderstandings that something has taken place. I am bound, there is Sharira, I have Sharira, Brahma is Srishti Siti Laya Karana, there is a Srishti Prakriya. It has to be only in this manner. Elsewhere, Bhagavan Bhashyakara says it is not random Srishti, not like, you know, this some berries thrown. It is not random. The berries can fall anywhere. There is a methodology to creation. It's not a fact. It's not idam mittham. Elsewhere, it is said that the Srishti is random. Random does not necessarily mean any which way. The comparison is with Swapna. The way this Swapna can be random, but still you see some meticulous order there. Even if Swapna is random, Swapna is really random. If you look at it, you are doing something in Swapna, then some other time you are doing something else. Within moments, things change. But then we do not think that we are dreaming. Unless, of course, we are trained so much, we have trained our mind so much that we can inquire in the Swapna, which is possible, but then it takes a lot of effort. But in Swapna, the way it appears to be, everything seems to be perfectly set up. It looks like my life, although it is all random, still I think that the creation has a systematic, meticulous order in place. Then why would I not feel this Jagrat Prapancha similarly to be meticulously set up, although it is random? It can be. However, none of it is real. All the vague ideas that we have, there is a particular way of creation, there is karma, karma phala data, then there is karma phala, there are gender, there is, you know, vriksha jiva, there is prani jiva, pakshi jiva, kita jiva, devata jiva, manushya jiva, rakshasa jiva, all these ideas which are there, all these are mere misunderstandings of the same Brahma Tattva. Therefore, the Mahavakyas will also work in the same order, including the Mandukya Prakriya, to take away erroneous notions. Each word works against its opposite to take away misunderstandings. It takes away the limitations of other words. Some other words will bring in, it will reveal a part and bring in some other limitation. Those limitations are taken away by some other words which are there in the Mahavakya. Satchidananda Brahma Lakshana Vakya otherwise. But all Prakriyas work, have to in the end work in such a manner that they take away all ideas. Na iti, na iti. Not karya. Na iti, neti, neti. The first na is not karya. Oh, how about karana Brahma then? Brahma is karana. No, not karana also. Jagat Karana also, Brahma isn't. That is Neti Neti. When he says Sad Brahma, oh Sad Brahma, then Sad Brahma, then Sat, how? Like Ghatapatadi Sat. No, Chid Brahma. Then Chid Brahma says it is not Jada like Ghatapatadi, it is Chaitanya Vastu. Oh Chaitanya Vastu. But then Chaitanya, there are so many Chaitanyas. No, Ananta Brahma. So all these ideas which are there, which are formed around each and every word. We have Pada Padartha Nitya Sambandha. They will bring in some limitation because we land on some Padartha. Those have to be taken away by other words. But the words can do only so much. Then what about the mind? Can you do Upasana? Definitely not. Upasana you can do, but not for Moksha. As a means to Jnanotpatti, it is possible, but the Brahma Tattva is not Upasya either. Therefore, Yato Vacho Nivartante Aprapya Manasa Saha. That is the meaning when you say even Brahma Shabda is Vachyartha. That is the meaning means Brahma Shabda will always remain Vachyartha. It will never be Lakshyartha. When will it be called as Lakshyartha? When Brahma Shabda inquiry takes away every erroneous meaning also of Brahma and lands you on nothing objectifiable. What you really are revealed on your own. You are revealed on your own even in the samsara avastha, but with the limitations of the body, mind, sense complex and all the Purana kathas, so to say, creation stories which have come up in Upanishads also, they are mere stories. There we consider ourselves samsari, jiva, therefore there is a samsara to be explained, which is explained by the Shruti by doing hand-holding. Just like the parent plays with the kid in a game, which is foolish really. foolish in the sense, for the kid it isn't. For the kid it is real. The kid makes tea. Let's say you have a daughter, a child who makes tea and says, you know, dad or mom, you have this, you know, appa amma have tea. There is no tea in the cup, but then you act along. So this entire Shruti acts along with the misunderstandings of the of her children, so to say. Because we see it as real, we derive pleasure from this samsara and we trap ourselves. Similarly, this entire creation story is a mere story. Thereby, everything that we base on the initial prapancha being there as a hypothesis, as an axiom we take it, then everything that is based on a on an erroneous foundation has to be an error. Elsewhere it is said in Bhashya, only if Janma Vikara is possible, then other five Vikaras and Shad Vikaras are possible. Sorry. If the first Vikara itself is not possible, Ajab Brahma, you are Ajab, Ajata Brahma, then this Ajata Brahmatma cannot have samsara. That is the Mandukya Prakriya. You deny the very first, you explain and deny, take away the erroneous notion of the first Vikara, whereby other Vikaras fall off. Now, all this has to be in the background when we look at this. Shuddha Chaitanantu Brahma Shabdase Lakshartha. Vachyartha will always, Brahma will always lead to Vachyartha, but Lakshartha Shuddha Chaitanya will always be of any Shabda, it will always be Lakshartha. Brahma, Tattva, Swarupa, our own Swarupa is always understood through Lakshartha, never through any Shabda, direct meaning of any word. That is the Vachyartha means direct meaning of the word. Lakshartha means the implied or the indirect meaning. It you have to have manana within, you have to have manana there. Even when it is a Shruti Vakya directly, the Shruti Vakya works by taking away. The Vakya itself works. Shravana, we have seen the Shravana Janya Jnana. What is that? Shravana Janya Jnana. It directly takes away the, which is, we have seen that it is Shrotrendriya Sambaddha Vakya. That Shrotrendriya Sambaddha Mahavakya is Jnana Karana and thereby Moksha Karana. But how? By taking away Ajnana. It is always by taking away Ajnana, which is the real way in which the Vakya is working, Shabda is working. And then what remains is you, which can never be limited. That is the Paramarthika Drishti, because Paramartha is you, who is the ever subject as long as there is an object and never an object. Tasmad Ishvara Brahma Shabdayor Ekaiva Arthah Pratiyate. So closing what he started with, he says, Shuddha Chaitanya being Lakshartha of Brahma Shabda and Maya Vishishta Chaitanya being Vachyartha of Brahma Shabda, therefore, and Lakshartha, Vachyartha leads to Lakshartha, both are same, and we have seen Maya Vishishta Chaitanya is not different from Shuddha Chaitanyat Anatirktam. Therefore, Ishvara Brahma Shabdayor Ekaiva Arthah Pratiyate Na Bhinnarthata. Both are same, really. The real meaning that when it is revealed, Ishvara also means the same Brahmatma Tattva that you are, Satchidananda Brahma, and the Lakshartha is also you. There is no difference between the two. Ishvara and Brahma means the same, because Maya Vishishta Chaitanya, another name for Maya Vishishta Chaitanya is Saguna Brahma or Ishvara, and Shuddha Chaitanya is called as Brahma without qualifying any which way, that is Nirguna Brahma. Both mean the same thing. That is why people, especially the so-called scholars who do PhDs, by analyzing without any sampradaya, they analyze what Bhagavan Bhashyakara wrote and they say he had misunderstandings. Imagine this, these people study the translations or some work in Sanskrit also. It's a limited learning. Ekadesha, that is also not real jnana, but then they think with textual analysis of translated words without even knowing how mimamsa is done, without taking the context or the entire work, the entire bhashya or the context of the Upanishad in perspective, they say in some chapters Bhagavan Bhashyakara misinterprets Brahma as Maya Vishishta Chaitanya, elsewhere he takes the Chaitanya, so he has not explained well. But they do not know that Ishvara Brahma Shabdayor Eka Eva Artha Pratiyate, it is the perspective that brings in difference. Therefore, what is the Vishesha? They do not know this Vishesha also, they do not know this Bhinnarthata Nasti. That is why they are confused, not Bhagavan Bhashyakara. Therefore, you have to see the context. Here he is explaining Tathapi Astyam Vishesha. Still, there is a difference between the two. What is the difference? That difference is Brahma Shabda Swarasata. Just a moment, please. Sorry. So, Brahma Shabdaha Swarasataha Laksharthaṁ Meva Prayashaha Bodhayati. Prayashaha, generally, prayena, generally Laksharthaṁ Meva Bodhayati, Brahma Shabda. When you hear the word Brahma, generally the word Brahma is used for Nirguna Brahma, Shuddha Chaitanya. Kvachit Katayatu Vachyartham Api. And at some places, Vachyartha also meaning Ishvara, Saguna Brahma. So Brahma generally means Nirguna Brahma, Shuddha Chaitanya. Sometimes it can also mean in context as the Vachyartha, which is Ishvara, Saguna Brahma, Maya Vishishta Chaitanya. Ishvara Shabda also similarly, the flip side is Ishvara Shabda also can mean both contextually. Ishvara Shabdastu Vachyartha Meva Prayasho Bodhayati. Generally, Ishvara Shabda stands for Maya Vishishta Chaitanya Saguna Brahma, but sometimes Laksharatham to Kvachit Kataya, sometimes can also stand for Shuddha Chaitanya or Nirguna Brahma. This is lost on many. One has to understand the context of the Upanishad as well as Bhashya, of the Vyakhyanakaras also, Tikakaras also. We should not think that they have confusion. Confusion is what we have. Otherwise, jnana does not bless. Jnana works only with whoever we study from, you know, whoever is the source of jnana. Whatever is the source of jnana. Take it Shruti, Guru, Vyakhyana, Bhashyakaras, Tikakaras, Tippanakaras. All of these in the sampradayas, when we say Dakshinamurti or Narayana is the Adi Acharya. Ishvara himself, who is none other than Nirguna Brahma, then when that knowledge is being revealed in the Sampradaya, we should not think that they are confused. Bhashya, there is no confusion in Bhashya. When we are unable to see what is hidden within, between the lines, then the context is lost upon us and then there is delusion. A jaundiced eye sees the world yellow. That is what it is said. Similarly is the case of all the so-called panditas. Panditam manya, says the Upanishad. Panditam manya. Idruk bheda sadbhavade laksharatham avalambya brahma shabdasya artho bhinnataya nirupitaha. Just, you know, I recall my Acharya's words, so I'll just mention it in this context. Especially, you know, when, you know, brahma shabda, Ishvara shabda is being analyzed, this has, you know, a lot of water has flown under the bridge. We have seen this. Those who have, you know, been on lists and, you know, have discussed with others, especially, those who have studied without Sampradaya, whether in India or mostly in outside India, these people have concluded or made assumptions that some Bhashya is by Shankaracharya, some is not by Adi Shankaracharya. All these ideas are there based on some analysis. They give some time value and, you know, the language. Whatever it is, that may be a research area for many, and it is just that, research area. It has nothing to do with jnana. For us, it does not matter who is backing it. For us, what matters is whether that jnana is wholesome, whether it is in it's in keeping with Shruti based Tarka. If it is so, then we really do not care whether it is Bhashyakara or Tippanakara or Tikakara or whoever it is. It is not so. And if we see erroneous things there, then we should test our knowledge first. And what Acharya used to say is, the more you put the source on a pedestal, higher you put the source on the pedestal, the stronger the jnana will flow. So, I mean, the force of jnana, when the Shruti reveals something, when the Bhashya reveals something, when the Tika reveals something, Tippana reveals something, anything when it is revealing something, that jnana is to take away ajnana. Jnana and ajnana, we've seen, is virodharthenanj. So jnana has to be stronger to work on ajnana. And this is also in the context of why jnana doesn't work. Many people ask, why jnana doesn't work? They think that jnana doesn't work. I've seen earlier, some of the students here have attended Kathopanishad, Bhashya. When I was teaching this, even after that, there's some who have fallen off the class, some who have not continued, or some who have joined another class and dropped off. Jnana doesn't work. Why doesn't jnana work? That Shraddha may be lacking, or there is an expectancy that I have to do something. As a student, I have to do something. But then, yato vacho nivartante aprapya manasasa is misunderstood. They think that vak won't work. Vak works, but the way it works is by laksharatha, where manana is needed. Manana is lacking. How will the jnana work? Shraddha is lacking. In the sampradaya, I'm not saying lacking, but then sometimes we have to analyze. I may say that I have Shraddha, but do I really have it? My behavior, is it so? Am I questioning each and every unit of knowledge that comes to me? So the more you put the source on a pedestal, that Shruti is at such a high level, is flawless, so to the Bhashya and Tika Ityadi, then the jnana, like water, flows with more force when it is at a higher level. Similarly, jnana flows with a force, and then it can work on a jnana. Anyway, this is an aside. I just wanted to mention this. I recalled some golden words of our Acharya. I had to mention it. So, Ishvara Shabdastu Vachyartam Prayasha Bodhayati Lakshyartam Tu Kvachit Kadaya. So, we should not say, Ishvara word has been used. Why is he saying Shuddha Brahma? All these notions should be dropped, because I've seen this many a time, and that's why this comes to mind as to people. They are not same, but in context, the word stands for, the Shabda Mimamsa is not easy. It is not just reading and trying to understand. That's why Sampradaya is needed to show you as to which word can be used in which manner. Dictionaries have so many meanings. We cannot just sit with a dictionary and assume meanings. Sometimes we can do that. It helps learning Vyakrana, not Vedanta. Nonetheless, idrug bheda sadbhavadeva laksharatham avalambya brahma shabdasya artho bhinnataya nirupitaha. So, brahma shabdasya artha bhinnataya nirupitaha. It is explained in different manners because there is a consideration to be made of a context. Idrug bheda sadbhava. There is a difference. Although there is no difference, sometimes difference is there. And although generally there is difference, sometimes there is no difference between Ishwara and Brahma. Now, this topic of Aikya has been closed for the time being, and Bheda being real has been refuted. Now, there is Shruti Pramana for Bheda Siddhi, which was quoted by Tattvadrishti earlier by quoting Dvasuparna Mantra. Dvasuparna Sayuja Sakhayaha. So, their Bheda Siddhi is there from Shruti. If there are such possibilities that Shruti talks about Bheda between Jiva and Ishvara, then Dvasuparna iti Shrutya Jiva Brahma Bheda Avagamyata iti, that doubt which was raised, Akshepa, Anyatha Karmopasana Vidhi Vayarcham iti cha Shankaya Samadhanam. The Shruti is revealing Bheda. If Bheda weren't there, Shruti one wouldn't have talked about it. That's one point. Second point is that, meaning this Dvasuparna mantra is revealing dvaita, not advaita. That's one part. Second part is anyatha. Anyatha meaning if this Shruti weren't revealing dvaita, meaning bheda between jiva and brahma, then karma wouldn't be possible, upasana wouldn't be possible, and the vidhi that the Shruti has on karma and upasana, that will become vyartha. So karma upasana vidhi vayartham iti cha shankaya samadhanam. These doubts are dealt with as raised by Tattva Drishti in the next set of avartas. We'll look at in the next part of. We didn't do much today in terms of coverage, but I hope it would be helpful later, especially when such contexts come up in whichever grantha you are studying. Sukham nityam suprakasham vyapakam namam adhishthanam buddhi buddhyam buddher dukyatva nirmana param sarva vedanta vidyam pratyak param maha tadeva annamattva iti me nishchita matihi. I'll see you in the next part. Namaste.
Namaste.